Hey guys, Yuri at Stankenda here. Today we're going to do a review of one of the most common boring mills in North America, at least in Canada, 4-inch TOS W100 horizontal boring mill. Machine came from Czechoslovakia, now it's the Czech Republic, and as far as I understand, as far as I remember, machine was built in two different configurations. One type of machine used to be called TOS W100, and second one was TOS W100H, which we have right now here. The major difference in between TOS W100 and A model is so 100 is a little bit smaller version of it. It does not have so much cross slide travel because it does not have this particular extension for the bed, like an outrigger for support the carriage. So which means it's limited for capacity and also limited for cross slide travel. I only see one machine like that. Rest of the machine is the same, like TOS W100, and majority, I would say, of the machines has a symbol A on it, so which is a little bit bigger machines. So let's go over some main machine specification, and then we'll go review of each individual components. The table size of the machine is 50 by 50 square table. Longitudinal travel for the table at Z axis is 50 inches. Cross slide travel, 63 inches. For vertical travel for the head is 45 inches. Spindle retract at 36 inches. Spindle diameter is 100 millimeters, just slightly smaller than 4 inches. And the faceplate diameter is 24 inches. If you count the number of axes on this machine, we're gonna get 6-axis machine. Cross-slide longitudinal, table rotation number 3, up and down for the head, spindle in and out, and also number 6 is a faceplate. The boring mill has a little bit different design compared to most common units. It's a mirror machine, it's 100 degree machine, so in most cases, operator, when he stay in front of the machine, the headstock located on the right-hand side from the operator. In this case, operator has a headstock located on the left-hand side. It's not really big deal. We only running one axis in same time, so people get used to it and there is no issues. So when you have a headstock on your left hand side. So here we have a headstock for the machine. So headstock, massive unit, which sitting on the box weighs for the column. The weight of it is about a couple ton and it's supported by the counterweight, which sitting inside that column there and connected to the headstock by the chain and through the rollers on top. The motion for the headstock provided by that lead screw, which moving that headstock up and down. On the left hand side, we have a shaft, which is provides the feed to the table. So every single motion of this machine is coming from here, from the headstock, from that motor on the back. There is no other main motors on it beside we have coolant motor and lubrication pump motor. So one motor riding entire machine. What we have here? Let's start from the left. Right here we have overload clutch reset. If by any means operator crash the machine or hit something or over travel the machine, there is a special mechanism inside which will disconnect by certain torque, and in order to reset it you would have to pull this handle up. Right here we have a side glass for the oil flow. On the bottom we have the same one for oil level. The capacity of the oil is about 20 liters, so you definitely need to watch those two. Side glass here and oil flow on top. Right here we have a handle which used for changing gears. So in order to change gear, you would have to move this handle up. And on the right hand side we have a dual selection dial. So you have external dial and internal dial. External dial is made for speeds, for the spindle and for faceplate. Internal one is meant for your feeds. So you're only going to turn one at a time. You select your speed, for example, right here, and only in up positions, then you have to move the handle down. Same apply for the feet. You would select your feet and move the handle down to engage it. And your running position gonna be always down for this handle. On the right hand side, we have a little bit confusing dial for our speeds on external side and for feet on internal side. So how to read it properly? In this area, where we have those zeros on the black and red range, we have only spindle connected. The spindle speed can be adjusted anywhere from 45 to 1120 RPM. However, you can still able to spin your spindle slower, but in this case, you would have to go into this section, and in that section, you're gonna have your spindle locked with a faceplate, so they're gonna spin together. So, and you have extension up to 7 RPM on your lower end for your spindle speed in that area. Right here, we have a dial for feet, and you have four circles here, and depends where this handle located, this multiplier for your feet, you're gonna get appropriate number of your feet. Say, like if you have gray or brown or purple ranges here, you just set up your handle here and your feet's gonna change accordingly. In the middle of the headstock, we have six position handle, which provide us a selection for which part of the machine gonna be moved. Say, like on the bottom two, we have everything going to the table for three axes there. In the middle, we have spindle feet, and on the top side, we have either head up and down, and also this segment works for the face plate slide motion. Right here, this long handle is probably one of the most important handle on the headstock. It's responsible for the rapid travel and for feet. In up position, we engage in the feet, and in on the bottom position, we engage in the rapid. The thing about this handle is, so when you engage in your feet in one direction, say like table going towards yourself, when you change it to neutral and then you move this handle down, your table going away from you, so rapid has opposite direction from your feet direction. On the left hand side, on the bottom, we have inside handle and top handle, which is controlling our feed rates from low to high, and right on top we have a segment which allows you to cut the thread with the spindle, but you would have to change some change gears on the left hand side. Right here we have a handle which responsible for speed ranges. We have a blue range, zero, which is disconnecting the spindle, and green one for our spindle. And on the very left hand side we have a lock handle, lock position for spindle and faceplate. So when you have this handle in this position, those two things, spindle and faceplate, spinning at once. Right here we have spindle on off handle. On the left hand side, your spindle feet not gonna work. For the right position, zero, there is no spindle feet, even if you engage it right here. On the bottom handle, you engage in basically your slide for the faceplate in the right position, and on the left position, it's disconnect. Right here in the middle, we have control wheel, which allows you to control every single component of this machine. And this one is included table rotation, in and out, cross travel, head up and down, as well as spindle in and out, and a faceplate motion. So handle has two positions, inside position and outside position. So for outside position, you have your spindle in and out control. For inside position, depends where this handle located, you can move your table or your head up and down. See, I'm turning this handle and I have the shaft spinning. So depends where selector handle is located, we can move the table or turn it or crosswise motion accordingly. On the right hand side, we have control panel. It has coolant control, our jog button, lubrication, machine start, stop, and power selection. You can run machine at 4 kilowatts or 10 kilowatts, which is 12.5 horsepower, and our emergency stop button. All this being said, just imagine how many gears we have inside. This headstock is packed with gears. If you're gonna open this cover, every single point behind it, it's gonna be gears, gears, and gears, and gears, just packed with it. So if you have any issues with the machine, you probably better to seek for professional aid to do some repairs inside. Let's go through some advantages of this design of the headstock. Firstly, nicely supported spindle. Spindle has double rolled cylindrical roller bearings for support, also large truss bearings for the spindle support on the back side. The spindle diameter is 4 inch, face plate is a decent diameter, so you can do variety of work with it. And regarding the spindle, spindle was made in two configurations. One was Morse 5 taper, and second one is 50 taper, 724. For Morse, you would have to use your wedge tool to extract your tooling from there. For 50 taper tool, there is additional motor on the back side of the spindle. So, and right here you would have a buttons. This machine is prepped for it, but not equipped with, for your tool clamp and unclamp. On the left-hand side of the headstock, we have extension for our spindle. Right here we have a lock. By moving handle to the right, you can lock your spindle in place. It's not gonna move on you. Down below, we have oil lubrication station. If this unit is set in program mode, every component of the machine gets lubricated every so often, depends on the timer, for a certain period of time. Right here, we have electrical cabinet. Early age machine has all electrical components, basically like contactors, relays and stuff. Late machines was supplied with PLC control installed in it. For the crosswide area and table area, what do we have? We have 50 by 50 table. It's three axes right here. Like I mentioned before, longitudinal travel, carriage sitting on the three box ways. The surface of those bed ways is pretty wide, and you barely gonna see machines with major wear on the longitudinal travel. Same apply to the crosswide area, so we have two major box ways here. Usually machine come with cover which protects this area. This machine has lack of it, it's missing. Right here we have a table which is able to spin against the crosswide. Another advantage of this machine, each individual axis has own locking devices and mechanisms. This apply to the headstock. On the bottom side of the headstock, we have a locking handle which is locking the headstock on the bedways. For the table, each corner of the machine has a locks, one, two, and on opposite side we have another two. Same apply to the table. We have table locking handle here. Sorry, that one is for handle. This handle is for table rotation. And same one for the longitudinal travel. For that axis, we have a handles on each corner of this carriage. On the bottom here, on this side here, we have a selection handle, which allows you to control individual motions. By moving this handle, three position, we either selecting our Z travel, cross travel, or table rotation. The major problem of this whole construction I can see so far, it's a lubrication. As we mentioned before, the lubrication pump sitting right behind the machine, and it's relatively extended pipes going through the back of the machine, through the cable carriers, going to the Z-axis table and table rotation. It supply oil to the crosswide screw, every single point, as well as supplying oil to the headstock. This mechanism using long, relatively long manifolds, and they manually adjusted for the flow. You have an individual adjustment screw for each individual lubrication point. When machine used for extended period of times, those holes might get plugged or something, and this might cause a lack of lubrication or exceed lubrication for some points, and which might lead to the machine extensive wear. On the bottom side here, we have a protection guard for our outrigger. So this stripe is protecting the surface this way. It's going inside, going around the roller and going out that way. So there is minimal amount of dirt can go under it. So everything nicely well protected. So let's do the quick spin of the machine. We'll see how it's working. Let's select probably the spindle only. And let's go to the minimum speed. So we move the handle up. Using this external dial and set it up at this range right here, so which is gonna give us 45 RPM when we in blue position right here. 45 RPM. So now, if we want to change the speed, we can move this handle to the neutral position. Wait until machine stop, and then we're gonna go to the green position here, which will raise our spindle speed about 5 times. without changing speed on this dial. So 225 RPM. So let's do the maximum speed in this range where only spindle rotating. We're gonna turn this dial to the very right position and we're gonna get 225 on the blue range here. Same speed. And now we're gonna do maximum speed of the spindle, which is 1120 RPM. RPM right here, nice and smooth. And let's do the test of the faceplate. We'll see how that thing works. So we're gonna do 7 RPM, which means we're gonna get 7 RPM for spindle and faceplate together. So operator deciding what he is using. Say like if you only gonna use your faceplate, in this case you would have to remove the tool from the spindle, move the spindle all the way in and mount your tooling on the slide and use a faceplate in this case. Or if you're using your spindle, you mount your tool in the spindle and using your spindle, not worry about your faceplate spinning. So move the handle up, one click to the right, handle down, 7 RPM, and we should be in this case on the very left position. Right now we're on neutral, spindle is not spinning because like we mentioned before, bottom handle is sitting at zero, so spindle not spinning. We'll come back to it a little bit later. So left position. So here is our 7 revolutions per minute. So as you can see, we have both units rotating, faceplate and the main spindle. Stop it and let's do a little bit of more speed. The maximum speed of this faceplate is 224 RPM. So we're going up, turn this thing and go to our maximum possible speed. For such diameter, it's pretty quick, pretty fast. Stop. And let's get back to normal speed. We're gonna engage machine probably at about 300 RPM for the main spindle, and we're gonna test our speeds and fits. So we set up spindle at 355 RPM, so faceplate not gonna spin on us, and we'll do the test for the speeds and fits. So, direction selection handle. In this position, we have engagement for the table, for the two bottom positions. So in order to engage the table, we move the handle up, and in this case, we have table rotation. If I move the handle down into the neutral position, table will stop, but at the same time, when I move it down, our table rotating in opposite direction from the feet. Now, to change direction here, we would have to move this handle to the left. Our feet is going counterclockwise now, neutral, and rapid going clockwise. Now, if we would like to change the speed rate, feed rate, we would have to use this handle right here. We go to the minimum possible feed rate. And you're probably not gonna see the table rotating, but you can judge by looking at this shaft here, how fast it's going, and it will give you an idea. So I put a neutral again, and I move right now this handle to the maximum position, the maximum speed. And since this range is really, really aggressive, we would have to reduce the spindle speed probably to minimum. So let's go to 45 RPM here. 45 RPM, and we would have to probably reduce it right here for our feed rate. So which is gonna be right here. Engage it and let's see what happens. This is third range. We on slowest feed rate on this handle, but we're still spinning pretty fast. Let's get back to neutral, to about square position. And now what we're gonna do, we're gonna check other two motions for the table. So for doing so, we would have to move this handle to the middle position. And right now we're gonna get our crosswise travel. All the way to the right, we're able to move Z axis. Let's do a little bit more slower speed right here. We'll go a little bit faster here. And we'll move our faceplate slide and spindle and head up and down. So let's do the test of our spindle in and out feed. So to do so, we would need to move selection handle to third or fourth position. Let's start the machine. So right now we have a in feed, and at the same time, if we move this handle down, we actually cannot do it because it's an interlock. We would have to pull this handle out, and now we have a rapid for the spindle out. Change direction. Up and down motion. Head down. Head up. Now, as you can see, we have in same time, we have a spindle going in and out. In order to disconnect it, we would have to put this handle into the neutral position. And right now we only have head going up and down. When you're moving handle up, head's gonna get the feet drive to it. The last motion we're gonna check here, we're gonna check the face plate slide operation. So in order to move it, we're disconnecting spindle from drive. We put spindle drive to zero here. This handle should be set to faceplate engagement. And small handle for directional, gonna be right in the middle position 3 and 4. So let's start the machine. As you can see, spindle and faceplate not spinning, but we're still able to run the machine for any single motion. So let's check our slide. So slide going in, we're not gonna touch that spindle. And slide going out. So let's bring it back to neutral. Disconnect it here. See, in this motion, we still able to run our feet. We can move the head up and down without spindle and faceplate rotation. Same apply to the table. Table still able to go in both directions, crosswise and for rotation. The last unit we're gonna talk about here is this unit right here. It's an optical device which made here for set up the table at exactly 90 degrees. So say if you doing a workpiece, you have a gearbox or something else which require to index at 90 or 180 degrees, you can activate this unit. On the bottom of the table, each side has a mirror with very, very fine line on it. And you look into that glass and you should line up two lines of this unit with line on the table. And this is gonna give you a start point. When you're doing your indexing, you're rotating your table 90 degrees. You need to catch the same line at that position so you know you at 90 or 180 or 270 degrees. Guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Hope it's gonna help you to understand how this machine works. So if you like it, please click subscribe button, click on notification, and we'll see you in next video.